See, this is the topology, okay?
Okay.
So I have a checkpoint management server in my head office, okay, which have IP address 10.1.1.251. Okay, I have a checkpoint head office firewall here, okay, and it is connected with the internet. I also have a one branch office firewall and another branch office firewall. Okay. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
So basically, this is the topology. Okay.
Well, once again, explain this topology.
See, I have a checkpoint management server in my head office. I also have one head office firewall. Okay.
Okay.
And I introduced two branches. Okay. Branch office. Okay. BO1
two branch office firewalls.
Yeah, and BO2 firewall. Okay. These are the BMnet 4 and all the information. BMnet 4 okay. inside. This there is a BMnet 7 for inside. Okay.
Okay. Once again, yesterday task we are doing now freshly.
Yes, yes, yeah. Yeah. Same.
Okay.
Yeah, the deployment of branch office from the freshly only. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So this head office have the external this public IP which is 192.168.0.250. This one have a public IP 192.168.0.150. And this has a 192.168.0.50. Okay. It's a private IP, but I have considered this
150. Okay, okay, you are using.
Yeah.
Totally this one put it bridge one.
Yeah, yeah. All the
192 series is the 192.168 is the bridge series.
Yeah, yeah, bridge series. Okay.
Okay.
Bridge interface.
With what about VMnet 4.5 that thing? What
see, this is 4.5. This is inside. This is VMnet 4 and 5 also I have connected with the firewall branch of a firewall 1. I use VMnet 7 with inside in a branch of a firewall 2. I also have VMnet 8 and 9 with branch of a firewall. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Because I need only these inside interfaces. Okay.
Yeah, inside interface we are getting ping or not. We need to check it only.
Yeah, yeah. That's why.
Yeah. Once again, open VMware.
So let me open the VMware here. See, this is
in the VMware. Open edit. Yeah. Virtual adapters.
I have lots of adapters there, I think.
Yeah, you show me first how many adapters. I will take that one is snapshot. Okay, 1.10.2. Okay. 7 for 7.7.7. 8 for NAT. That one. Okay.
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 I also have one more bridge. Okay, bridge is not showing here.
Yeah, bridge zero. That one will be coming later. Change settings. That will show you later.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay.
Okay.
I'll set it the IP address. So these are the IP address in my head office firewall.
So how many adapters connected? Once again, show me.
This four. This is the same. BNet 1, 2, 3. This is one is bridge. Okay.
Okay.
This one. BMnet, this is bridge, BMnet 4, 5 and 6. Okay.
Okay.
And if you want to see the IP scheming here, then I just now I run this command. Let me cp state os-f5config. Okay, these are the IP address. Okay, 192.168.0.150, 10.4.4.250, 10.5.5.250, 10.6.6.250. Okay.
Okay.
Same code here. .7.7.250. Okay. Same thing. So.
Okay.
Let me start my configuration there. Okay. So see, I just added this one only. I nothing do this one. I just added. Okay. I does not enable the this secure internal communication also. I just added.
What about here NAT? Once I can check the NAT.
NAT is, I configure NAT with this one. There is a NAT. NAT with the my management server. Okay.
Okay.
Same automatic static net. Automatic static net. okay, with the 192.168.0.249. okay. So now let me add one more object also there. So more object into network object, network and servers here, new gateway. Okay. So if I give the name checkpoint branch office to firewall, okay. IP address is 192.168.0.50. Okay.
Okay.
I enable the firewall blade only. I didn't touch this thing. Okay. This secure internet connection right now. I just give the OK button. Yes. See. If I see my gateway here. It is added here, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So now you also remember this thing, that connection in net tab, we have to select this one. Okay.
Okay.
I told you yesterday also this thing. So now I am installing the policy first. Okay. I install the policy in my head office firewall only first.
Okay.
After that, I enable the SIC. Okay. So you just add, after that you enable the SIC after installing that these policies.
Before we don't want to add SIC.
No. Actually, sometimes it will work, sometimes it doesn't work. Okay.
Okay.
See, I am installing the policy in my gateway only, this head office firewall only. Okay. I see this issue first time. Okay. That's why. Okay. Maybe there is some bugs in this latest R80.10.
Okay.
For me also, it is not working. So that's why I use this one, then after that is working fine for me.
Okay.
If I log in here, admin entry 123 cp conf sic status. Not sic state, just established with admin, that is fine. So all installation also succeed after some time. Today also I show you how to configure site to site VPN. Okay.
Okay.
And now VPN is started. So today site to site VPN, tomorrow DM VPN. Okay. Which we call in route based VPN in checkpoint.
Okay. And DM VPN name.
Yeah, DM VPN in Cisco language. Checkpoint called route based VPN. Okay.
Okay.
And today class we complete the site to site VPN for domain based VPNs. Okay.
Okay.
Domain based means we define the access list in Cisco, right? These are the we call in checkpoint domain based. In Cisco, we call on the basis of traffic selector, right?
Okay.
Okay. So now I just enabling the SIC. Okay. Communication ASDFGH initialize the trust. Trust is initialized. Okay. I'll also get the topology information. Okay. Let me also stabilize the trust with this firewall. Okay. Communication ASDFGH initialize. Trust is established. Okay.
Okay.
Close. Done. Now I go to into my security policy tab here. Okay. Security. So we have a security policies here, okay? The name of this security policy is standard, right?
Yeah.
Standard, okay. Let me not here.
You need to export.
No. I want to create one more security policy here. Manage policies and layers. Standard. So I want to create new action. New, okay. I create basically separate policy package for my branch of Spiral, okay. So this is a branch of checkpoint. Branch office 01 firewall, okay. Policy package, okay. Okay. So this is the
branch office firewall one.
Yeah, and now I'm going to edit this one. Here I select the installation target. Okay. Not all gateway, specific gateway. Which is branch office one firewall. Okay.
Okay.
Now I also add one more. This is for checkpoint branch office 2
FW
policy package, okay. Here I call the dead gateway branch office again, okay.
Okay.
Now let me close this one. So here we get three packages, right? Standard for branch office, this head office firewall. This is for branch office firewall, right? And this is for
branch policy tab. It open for policy tabs.
Okay. So now I am going to add one rule here. Internet access, okay. There I create new object, okay. One network object. Here I give the name inside BO01, okay. Which is 10.4.4.0. Actually, that is the right way to write the policies because we have lots of firewalls, right? I'll also enable the net rule here. Translated hide mode net, hide behind the gateway. I'll select the branch office one firewall. Okay. So this net rule install on the branch office
branch office firewall.
Okay.
You are sitting in head office, so you are controlling all firewalls.
Yeah.
One second, show me in the home branch. Where is the firewall tab?
Let me complete this thing, okay?
Okay, then after show me.
DNS, here I allowed these ports. HTTP.
Ping, ICMP.
Yeah, HTTP, HTTPS, ICMP. ICMP reply and ICMP request, okay. Send is accept. Track log here. Here I also enable login. Install on the branch office one firewall. Okay.
Firewall one.
So let me. I'll created this policy here. Okay. So let me also install this policy. So I can use this one or this one, okay?
Any. In down one, this one is good.
No, we can use both, which we want. Okay, so I use this one, install policy.
Okay. Both are same or both are different?
No, both are same.
Okay.
So now we have a like separate policy package for all the firewalls. So we can move, or we can also use a standard policy package for, but the thing is what happened at time, we have to remember the rule, this rule for branch office one, or we have to create the section, this section for branch office one. So it's become complex sometimes. That's why I like to use this type of policy management thing.
Okay.
Now it is installing the policy only on the branch of a firewall. Okay. See branch of his package here. Okay. Let me install this policy package. Okay. Now installation in a process. Okay. So let me also go to into the branch office one firewall. Admin at the array 123. If I run fw state command here. So now initial policy is there. Okay.
Yeah.
Let the installation complete first.
One second, open standard.
Can you first complete this one? Okay. After data is go for a standard, not an issue.
And just for seeing that firewall is there added or not there.
No, I think I didn't add it there. Maybe. So we have to add it the same thing. Okay. And we call this one, this firewall in installation target.
Okay.
Finalizing. Come on, man. Become success. Yeah, I think it succeeded now. So policy is installed, right? Here we are also getting the name checkpoint branch office one firewall policy package. Okay.
Okay.
So like this, we configure the policies and all. Let me also go to here. So what you want to see here?
One second. Standard here added. Firewall is added or not?
Let me edit this policy. Installation target. I didn't add it here. So I can add like this only. Okay.
Okay.
Then and install the policy. Okay. This policy installing into my head office firewall. See, if we install directly, okay, that time it asks select the policy package. So if we use this one standard, okay, this is for my head office firewall. Okay. So install now. So this policy installed on a head office firewall.
Okay.
If I use this button, that time it didn't ask. It directly installed in the head office firewall. Okay. If I click here, then it asks which policy package you want to install. Okay.
Okay.
That is the difference between this one and this one, I think. What happened in old version, we also have same thing. But this thing we have there here. Here also we have this one, okay? In checkpoint, we can do these things with several places, the same thing. There is also one beauty, if I modify this one, then it goes modified everywhere, okay?
Everywhere. Yeah, you told me that this
yeah, that thing I think I told you in a starting. Okay.
Yeah.
That is also a best thing. In Palo Alto, there is nothing like this. Right? If we change the IP address in an interface, then we got lots of problems with the net and all these steps, right? So Stolichnik succeeded. Now let me also create policies to my branch of a second firewall. Okay. Basic internet. Okay. I create a new object for this one. Network object. Inside BU02. Okay. This is a 10.7.7.0 network. 255.255.255.0. Net. I add a hide mode net for this guy. I install this one into branch of a second firewall. Okay. Second branch of his firewall. Let me also call some services here. DNS. HTTP. And ICMP. Reply and request. Okay. Let me also choose the login here.
Here it does not work, drag and drop.
Yeah, here what? Everything will work. We can do like this.
No. I'm not saying not this way.
Okay.
Suppose next task to copy paste, just like.
Copy paste, no, I think. We have to do some work, I think so. Install the policy. If I run this one, then it install the policy onto this firewall only. Okay. If I run this one up that time, I need to select the.
It will ask the policy, what policy and
everything. Yeah. On which policy package you want to install it. See, it is asking. So I go for the branch of a second policy package. Okay. Actually, I like this way because we have a separate rules for every firewall, right?
Yeah.
So if we do any modification, then we know where it is. We did some modification, all these stuffs there. So deployment of branch firewall is completed. Okay. Now the next thing is VPN. Okay. You also want to test some traffic.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Okay, then. So I have this PC here.
Okay, this one connected for which VM adapter PC?
Right now it is connected with VM Net 1. So I am going to.
Okay.
I am changing to VM Net 4. Okay. This is my branch office firewall inside interface, right? VM Net 4.
Okay.
Done. Window R. Yeah, it goes hand now. Here I change the IP address, okay?
4.4.4.4.4.101,
okay? 4.4. Use public DNS, okay? Because if I have VPN connection, then I not need to change this DNS information also. Because through VPN it go to head office DNS server, right?
Okay.
Let me connect this guy also. So it is connected now. CMD ping 10.1.1.250. It's not 4.4. I am able to reach to my gateway. Okay. Now let me ping it to Google public IP. Okay. Right?
Just yeah.
If I also open, try to open the Google. www.amazon.com. It is opening Amazon. Okay. If I check the login here, then 4.4.101, right? I'm getting the logs. Okay, origin is from branch office firewall 1, right? I'm getting the login information, everything there. Okay, so this is the way we can deploy these firewalls and all these stuff. Okay.
Okay. Next time I will put any change in the adapter and change the IP address, it will be work out.
Yes, sure. It will be work.
Okay.
See, now if you want to see the in branch office second, then I make this one as a 7. Okay. And I change the IP address also. Inside interface, let me change my IP address. Here I am using
7.7.
7.7.
And down also 7.7.
7.7. Down. Let me change the log here now. 7.7, because I have only one PC, that's why I'm using window R CMD. First I ping my gateway 7.7.250. It is pinging. Now I'm trying to ping the Google. It is pinging. Okay. If I check the log here, I'm getting the logs, right? Origin from branch office second firewall. Okay. Ping to the Google public here. I'm getting this message. Okay.
Okay.
That is the way. Now I connect this one with my head office firewall only. Okay.
Okay.
So I make this here. I change the IP address. Ten dot one dot one 10.1.1.221. Can you also 4.2.2.2, that is right. Let me again ping to the Google. I am pinging, right?
Yes.
If I see the login again, I am getting the log for this one also. Okay. 8.843. It is 8.43, right?
Okay.
So now let me start the VPN. Okay. Side to side VPN. Okay.
Okay.
So you are aware of the theory, right? So I show you the practicals only. Okay.
Okay.
So
just tell me which type of VPN we are enabling. What? How many types are there? Just enough.
Okay. See, let me complete the side-to-side VPN today. Okay. Tomorrow I will tell you all the type of VPN in firewall in checkpoint. Basically, we have a lots of type of firewall. This VPNs, lots of VPNs.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Okay.
I'll explain with some PDF with you. Okay.
Okay.
Today you just see we are doing site-to-site VPN on domain-based site-to-site VPN. Okay.
Okay. What is the topology? Can you show me on second topology?
The same topology.
Same topology.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So in site-to-site VPN, first step is I am going into my firewall here. I'll enable the IPsec VPN blade. Okay.
Okay.
First thing.
Okay. This is for home branch firewall.
Yeah, this is for home. Okay. Head office firewall. Okay.
Head office branch. No, head office firewall.
Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now the second thing, I am also enabling we lost the connection. Domain at the rate 123. Okay, so do one thing. I'll change the steps. Okay. Let me open the notepad file. I change the step.
First of all, we need enable the blade IPsec.
Domain based VPN. Okay. I write all the steps. First step. We define the domain object group. Okay. Second step, we enable the IPsec blade and to link selection right. Okay. Do the link selection and define domain. Okay. Third step I write down later. Okay. So let me first create a domain object. Okay.
Okay.
This one is, we are creating a domain, this object group for all the subnets which are participating in the VPN. Okay. Local and remote.
Okay.
So here means we are defining the traffic. Okay. Cisco language. We are defining the Excel list, which basically makes the interesting traffic. Okay. For local and remote.
Okay.
So here we have a network object. Okay. Right click here and I add the group, network group. Okay. I give the name VPN
site to site
networks. Okay. I just give this name. Here I select my subnets. Okay. So I have a inside for head office. Inside for branch office 1 and inside for branch office 2. Okay.
Yeah.
So these are
added 3.
Okay. If we also want to add the DMZ networks, then we can. Okay. Here I am using only these 3 networks. Okay.
Okay.
Branch office 1, branch office 2 and head office network. Okay.
Okay.
I just click the OK button. Okay. So first step is completed. Okay. Now the second step, we enable the IPsec blade and do the link selection and define domain. Okay. So I am going to into my head office firewall.
Already you enabled it. I think so. Yeah,
IPsec blade is enabled. Okay.
Okay.
So Now let me go to into the IPsec VPN tab here. No, in net tab here. We have this, sorry, in network management tab, we have a VPN domain. Okay. Here we have a VPN domain. So all IP address behind the gateway are based on the topology, means it is basically selecting all the networks which is behind your gateways. Okay.
Okay.
But we want like a specific network only go with the VPN, right?
Okay. Yeah.
If we want all, then we can leave it default this one, or we can use the manual. Okay. And we select our that group, that VPN network group, right?
Which yes. Three are there in VPN network group. Three networks are there.
Yes. Yeah. So we define basically we enable the IPsec blade and also define the object. Okay. Now second step is link selection.
Okay.
The security gateway participate in the following VPN community. I leave it this one. See, in traditional mode, what happened? Basically, in RFT.10, they basically disable these methods. Okay, these
okay.
These encryption and hashing algorithms. Okay.
Okay.
So we have to select this one. Okay.
Okay.
That is the difference only with them. In previous version, they already have this one, but
by default selected.
Yeah, but here they not have this one. Okay. Exporter for secure remote, and I go to in advance also. I select this one. Okay. These are for DeFi element. Okay. All the group. That is the only extra step we have to do here.
Okay.
Now done. So in IPsec VPN traditional mode configuration, okay, here basically we are using the PKI certificates for the pre-shared key. Okay, we are not using pre-shared key, we are using PKI. Okay. We can also use PSK in later selection. Okay. So now I am doing here link selection. So here I select the link. Select address from the topology table. Okay. So I am using this one. This is my public IP. Okay. This is my outside interface IP. So I select this IP here. In VPN advance. See, there is also lot of VPN tunnel sharing, use the community settings, all these steps we have. Okay. So we leave it default for them. And okay. Same thing we did with the branch office one firewall. In network management, we have a VPN domain. So first we enable the blade. Okay.
Yeah.
Now in network we have a VPN domain here. So here we select that domain. Now in IPsec VPN traditional.
They everything are selected.
Yeah, some are selected. Okay. So I just selected them. Okay. Okay. Now I also select the link here. This is my outside interface IP, right?
Yeah, IP address of the.
Yeah. I leave it default. Okay, this thing.
Okay.
Okay, now I am going into my branch office firewall 2. I'll enable the blade.
I can check blade.
Network management good VPN domain. I define the domain. Into IPsec tab. I am going to traditional mode configuration. I enable these things here. Generally, what happens if we are creating VPN tunnel between this checkpoint and the business partner, like they are running at this Cisco ASA or Palo Alto or checkpoint also, that time we use pre-shared key. Okay.
Okay.
because these are all are the in the same, like same, they are belonging with the same company, right? So and they also have a same management server. So generally we use the PKI for them.
Okay.
Can I select the link here? This one?
Zero dot.
Done. So we are done with the first step, okay? Now third step is create VPN community. Okay.
Community, we have, community.
Yeah, we have two types of community, mass and star.
Okay.
Okay. So in mass, what happened? All the gateway create the VPN tunnel with all. Okay, means if this head office firewall have a VPN tunnel with the branch office firewall, okay, and branch office firewall have the VPN tunnel with head office as well with the branch office firewall. Okay.
Okay.
But in star community, what happened? The branch office firewall have a VPN tunnel with the head office only. Okay. So if the branch one and branch two users want to communicate, then their data go through the head office firewall. Okay. That is the difference between mass and star topology.
Okay.
So let me now create the VPN community here. So in policy settings here, we have a VPN community here. Okay. So I click on a VPN community. I add a new VPN community here. Star community or mass? I am using mass
community.
Okay. I give the name VPN site to site. Okay. We can give any name, depends on you.
Okay.
See, here we define the gateway information. Okay, participating gateways. So here we are selecting all the three gateways. Okay.
Okay.
Encrypted traffic.
We
use this one, accept all encryption traffic when we are doing the DMVPN. Okay.
Okay.
If I select this one, then we don't need to create any rules. Okay. But I need one rule for that. So I leave it uncheck here.
Encryptions.
Yeah. These are the encryption methods. Okay. In this one, if we want to configure the perfect firewall secrecy, then we just select it here. Okay.
Okay.
If we want to do the aggressive mode, then we have to select this one. It depends on you only. Channel management.
What about the PSK? When you need to select the PSK?
Yeah, I always like to use the perfect firewall secrecy.
Okay. Okay.
Internal management. See, we have a tunnel sharing. One VPN tunnel per each pair of host. One VPN tunnel per subnet pair. One VPN tunnel per gateway pair. I'll use this one. Means the thing is,
what is the meaning?
This meaning is this. Like we have a two subnet in head office. Okay.
Okay.
And we have a one subnet in branch office and one subnet in. So what happened? For every subnet, they create a one separate SA, separate tunnel. Okay.
Okay.
That is the meaning of this one. For each host of pairs, it is they create a separate tunnel for each pair. Okay. And for they create a one tunnel for a gateway pair only. Okay.
Okay.
I use generally this one. The default one.
Which one? One VPN per subnet.
Yeah, default one. Default.
Okay.
In excluded services, I only exclude this I here only. Okay.
Okay.
In shared secret, I am not using shared secret here. If I use, then I define the shared secret here.
Yeah. Okay.
Wire mode, we use this one. If I select this one, bypass firewall means it bypass all the inspection like FID inspection, URL filtering, all these type of inspection, it bypassed that time. Okay.
Okay.
It doesn't go for deep packet inspection. Okay.
Okay.
In advanced step, I use all the default here. See, I just select this one. Disable net inside the VPN community. Okay. Because I don't want netting. Right.
Okay. Inside of the VPN.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, okay. So now let me add the rule for this here also. So here I add one rule above this one. I give the name VPN01. Okay. In source, I call that VPN networks. I also call the same one to destination. See, because I want to allow the bidirectional traffic, right?
Yeah. So
that's why I use this one. In VPN community, I select the specific VPN community. Okay. Here I have my community VPN site to site, right?
Site to site. Yeah.
So I select this VPN community here. Okay. Action is accept. I allow for all the services here.
Okay.
Tracking is enabled also. And I select the policy installation target, okay, which is firewall one. Okay. That head office firewall.
Okay.
Now I'm going to the policy package of branch office firewall. Let me add one rule here. That becomes some extra overhead. If I use only standard, then I select select all the firewalls into one
place. Okay.
Right. VPN
firewall one. VPN BO branch office.
No, I just a rule name only. VPN 01.
Okay.
We can use any name. There VPN networks. Destination in VPN, I call my community site to site this one, and now action is
accept.
Log is enabled. Then
once again, show me that target installation on.
This is the CPBU1 firewall.
This one. Yeah. This one. This branch. Okay.
Yeah. I just drag and drop from here. Okay. Let me add one module here also. VPN01. VPN networks. Destination. Community, specific community, action is accept, track, select this target here. Okay. Now I am going to into my first firewall here. Okay. I am just installing this policy. Actually, tomorrow I am planning to create one notepad file for you.
Okay.
Where I mention all type of VPN, all these things. Because in Checkpoint and FortiGate firewall, we have a lots of VPNs.
Okay.
Like in Cisco routers, we have lots of similar here. I'll also show you one example with the start of Logi. Okay.
Okay.
So that time I need to only change the community, that's it.
Okay.
So I delete this community and I make a star community. And I show you how we can create this type of scenarios also. Generally, we use mesh community because we don't want extra overhead and bandwidth is a important thing in companies. VPN takes around 3 more days.
Okay.
After that, VPN is finished. After that, one class I take on this one. This
Which one?
IPS and anti-boot, all this stuff.
And okay.
One more class on this. That thing you want to also learn. This one, policy and this app and URL filtering are in RAT.10, right?
Okay.
I teach you this one. After that, maybe we complete the checkpoint also. Because other thing I completed, right?
Okay. One second, tell me. If you install 15 days licenses, sir.
Yes, yes.
Again, uninstall. Again, we can install. We are facing any problem?
No.
Okay. Tomorrow I will install. I already installed 3 firewalls, but I didn't activate it.
See,
I will activate tomorrow.
You installed and activated. Okay. And when like 10 days is completed. Okay. So you delete that thing and install a fresh firewall again. Okay.
Fresh firewall. What about the smart console access? That one is also fresh?
No, a smart console is not an issue. You need to install the fresh management server only. Okay.
Okay.
I think with the firewall, with the security gateway, we don't have any problem. Because all the license bind with the this management server only.
Management server. No, we didn't discuss here updations and how to install license.
License part.
Yeah.
Okay, I to tell you regarding license part. In update, there is a simple and this way. We just that there is only just we get the same type of updates maybe in RAT.10. Okay, otherwise we have separate updater there. In R76, we have a separate updater, a smart updater. Okay. It's like if you click on us, if you open the smart updater, there you get the view.
Okay.
Generally, people don't tell these updates and all these stuff in checkpoint. In parallel to these becomes important, but in checkpoint, because these are the very complex process. Okay. That's why.
Okay. I didn't get RAT.
I'll share with you RAT, I think, already.
Really? Today I check it, I didn't get.
I didn't share the video, yesterday video. I'll upload yesterday videos and this today class.
Okay.
Let the complete this installation first. Today class is going smoothly, right?
Yeah, I like very, very well. Great class. In the starting of the checkpoint.
Yeah,
very well. I like it.
See, the thing is now.
No, I didn't get R80. I get only for R76.
Okay, not an issue. Let me complete this thing after. I'll show you. Maybe. Okay. I already uploaded. Okay, so maybe I forget to.
Link.
Yeah. So let me ping to my branch office one. Okay. We also I can ping to my firewall IP.
Once again, check the IP address here. This is for 7 or 8 previously.
This one. This is my now I connect with my BM network.
Okay.
Okay. So I am pinging my firewall that. Branch of this firewall. Okay. So request timeout. Okay. Let me open my global properties here. accept ICMP is there. Okay, fine. So admin at the 123 BPN TU. This is the command, okay? BPN TU.
So okay.
List all I case if I press 1. Nothing is there right now. Okay. If I press 2, nothing. So let me enter the quit button. And so route. Yeah. Ping 192.168.0.1. It is pinging. 0.150. Yeah, it is pinging. 0.250. Yeah, it is pinging. Okay. 250 is the same.
The same file.
Yeah.
Got it.
And let me also admin at the 123. Ping 192.168.0.50. Yeah, it is able to ping 250. So
150.
So round 150 is the self IP.
Same. Okay.
Yeah, admin. I just want to check the connectivity first. Yeah, 192.168.1. Everything is fine. So it is connected with BMNet 1. IP config.
Once again, check the IP.
10.1.1.1. This one. Let me disconnect. Let me connect again. I to my management server.
Here to ping it. Ping.
Yeah. Now. See.
Yeah.
It is.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Created the essays. Ping is not working.
But ping is not working.
Not an issue.
GUI access. Once again, take GUI access from here.
7.7. Let me also ping this one. Okay, this thing is not working also. So where is my putty? I'll take the SHS, okay? 10.1.1.4.4.250. Okay. So I also want to check the IP address. So interface ETS 1. 10.4.4.250, right? It is not working. Yeah, but BPN is initiated. If I press to see, we have a BPN tunnel, right?
Yes.
If I go to here, BPN TU 1J, it shows the phase 1 assays, okay? We have a 2 assays, okay? We have a 2 tunnel with 192.168.50 and 10.1.1.250, okay?
250.
This is my head office firewall, okay?
Yeah.
It's showing this one because I added 10.1, this head office firewall as a 10.1.1.250, okay? Don't be confused with the IP address.
Yeah, yeah.
Because management server is only one, okay? That's why VPN TU. See, it has the SSH. Okay. It also has the this information there. So quit here. Let me check my asset. Let me enable the tracking. Let me also see the installation target. About the standard, any. See, 10.1.1.0 is trying to ping this, trying to HTTPS, right? It is allowing. It is allowing. Okay. Maybe there is a problem with something else. Okay.
Okay.
That okay. These are the VM. That's why. But we have a login information there. Okay. So don't worry.
Okay.
And let me standard this one is same. Let me install again this vulnerable package. It will work, ping will work, it must work. Okay. HTTPS 10.4.4.2.0 HTTPS 10.7.7.2.0 because this become now very complex, right? Complex diagram. That's why. IPsec network management we defined. VPN networks, that's fine. Network groups, we have a VPN network group, this one. Inside VO1, HO. Yeah, these are fine. 4.0.7.7.0 If I check this thing, see, these are the login information, right?
Okay, 177.101 only for okay.
Not this one, standard policy.
Expand source.
10.1.1.1 source is destination, this one. Okay. Just in this firewall, HTTPS it is allowing, right? Okay. So,
okay.
Not an issue. Or,
okay.
I can do also one more thing here. Let me window r sp.cpm. Let me go to into the branch office 1 bmnet 4 here. Time to connect. Properties.
4.4.100.4.4.
CMD IP config 10.4.4.250 pinging 1.1.250 did not be able to ping this guy.
Open PuTTY, check it once again with the telnet or anything.
Ten dot one dot 1.251. Okay. Let me do the SHS.
Check the logs in our server.
Yeah, we will see the logs here. Let me go to the second policy. 10.4.4.101, right? See, we are getting the logs here. Okay. 10. This one going to ICMP. This one, okay. I'll try this one, right? Okay. All are allowed, okay. So I don't know, maybe there is some problem with this, okay. Don't panic.
Okay.
Don't panic.
Okay.
We are done with this, our practical. And also, see, it is service this one, access rule, internet access. This one.
Everything is allowed here.
Yeah. Network, VPN networks. Any application, accept. Okay. So don't panic.
Okay.
Sometime what happened, actually I'll have lots of adapter. Maybe there is a ARP issue also.
Okay.
ARP-A. Because I'll use only one PC, right? Here and there. That's why. Into this here. VPN 1, VPN committee, VPN set to site, okay. Disable net inside the VPN committee, reset or VPN property. This is fine. Progress service, okay. Terminal management. set permanent channel. Encryption is fine. Custom. Okay, so that is the way we configure like this side to side VPN checkpoint. Okay.
Okay. Can you take remote access to my laptop?
Okay. Okay, not an issue. So let me end this meeting now. Okay. And we will see how with the start topology now. Okay. Tomorrow.
Okay. Okay.
Let me end this meeting. I'll call you with my phone. Okay.